Living in space, a grand aspiration for many, begs the question, can conventional space station designs actually make that dream a reality? The answer is a resounding no. To advance the boundaries of human spaceflight, we must seek bold and inventive solutions. This is where SpaceX's innovative strategy comes into focus, reimagining the colossal spaceship as a fully operational space station. The prospects inherent in this concept are vast, paving the way for innovative opportunities in the field of long-term space habitation. How does SpaceX intend to transform its rocket into a space station? Let's discuss more in today's episode of NR Studio. The future of the space station has emerged as a very prominent subject, especially given the impending retirement of the ISS. NASA has outlined a timeline. However, in the realm of space exploration, flexibility is paramount, especially given Musk's recent suggestion of expediting the deorbiting of the ISS. Regardless of the schedule, it is imperative to quickly prepare a replacement to maintain America's unbroken presence in space. If there is a company that is adamantly rejecting the idea of remaining passive, it is SpaceX. What sets SpaceX apart is not just its participation, but its highly innovative methodology, a concept that is fundamentally different from other commercial space station initiatives. Rather than developing a conventional modular station, SpaceX intends to transform its colossal spacecraft into a fully operational space station. While there may be skepticism, the benefits of this concept are undeniably compelling. The most obvious is its scale. Starship is vast in scale. Currently, the primary living area is limited to the payload compartment and nose cone, which stretches about 18 meters, 60 feet high. Despite these volume limitations, ambitious proposals have emerged, including a six-story configuration, with each level designated for a different purpose. One level could be designated for equipment and payload storage, while another could serve as a greenhouse and dining area. Additionally, there would be facilities dedicated to physical exercise, along with sleeping quarters, communal spaces, and management systems. This architectural design would facilitate a seamlessly integrated Earth-like habitat for astronauts. And remarkably, it could house dozens, potentially up to 100 people, more than the capacity of the ISS or previous space stations. However, this is only a glimpse of Starship's potential capabilities. Currently, most of its internal capacity is allocated to fuel tanks. If SpaceX were to strategize to eliminate or reuse these tanks, the habitable area would increase significantly, turning Starship into a sprawling station module. A fully optimized Starship has the capacity to provide approximately 50 meters of habitable space, with a diameter of 9 meters, culminating in an interior volume of approximately 3,000 cubic meters. This would triple the volume of the International Space Station. This would demonstrate that multiple individuals could inhabit and conduct their professional endeavors in orbit, with this evaluation not including potential future Starship developments, such as the anticipated V3 model, which could reach an impressive length of approximately 70 meters. This iteration could potentially increase the overall volume to approximately 4,400 cubic meters, thereby increasing the capacity for personnel, cargo, and systems on board. The scale of this design presents a significant advantage over conventional space station architectures, which typically support fewer than 20 occupants. The Starship station is set to operate not only as a research facility, but also as a driving force for the burgeoning commercial space tourism sector, creating new opportunities for those who dream of living among the stars. Another key element that elevates Starship as a formidable contender is its composition. Unlike the International Space Station, which is built from aluminum, Starship is made from stainless steel, a material known for its exceptional durability and resistance to corrosion, allowing it to survive the harsh conditions of space. Spaceship serves a critical function in protecting astronauts from radiation exposure, micrometeoroid collisions, and significant temperature fluctuations. Stainless steel exhibits exceptional ease of maintenance and repair, characteristics essential for long-term functionality in the space environment. Furthermore, stainless steel is also cost-effective, allowing SpaceX to optimize the efficiency of the station's construction while adhering to budget constraints. However, one of the most exciting advantages lies in Starship's reusability. While this attribute is often associated with launch economics, it also has significant implications for the operational dynamics of the space station. If a module experiences a problem, it can be retrieved and sent back to Earth for repair before the next launch. A capability that has not been possible with traditional station modules. This capability will greatly extend the operational life of the station and reduce the likelihood of failure during its orbital life. In addition, the station will benefit greatly from the extensive support provided by the entire SpaceX ecosystem, in addition to the benefits provided by Starship. Super Heavy, currently the world's most powerful launch vehicle, is specifically designed for deployment purposes. Refueling of markers can be closely monitored by the Dragon capsule, while Starlink integration will ensure seamless communications and continuous research activities. In conclusion, SpaceX's goals go beyond the simple goal of launching a space station. It will require the creation of an integrated orbital infrastructure. From a construction perspective, this process is expected to align with SpaceX's established operational paradigm, where Starship is first deployed into orbit and then modified through fuel tank extraction or reconfiguration to optimize the living environment. An alternative approach could involve developing a special variant of Starship on Earth, specifically designed for human habitation, that would require minimal modifications prior to orbital deployment. This iteration could incorporate additional thrusters, similar to those found on Dragon, to improve station keeping and facilitate orbital adjustments. A solitary Starship has the capability to operate as an independent space station. However, the real promise lies in the prospect of scaled operations. Rather than using a single module, SpaceX could build a vast orbital complex featuring a network of interconnected Starships, potentially numbering as many as 50. These modules could be arranged in a circular configuration connected to a central hub, forming a rotating wheel-like structure. This design proposes generating artificial gravity through centrifugal force, effectively addressing a major problem with prolonged space travel, the adverse health implications of microgravity on the human body. Given its unmatched size, the projected cost of a Starship-based space station is modest. SpaceX has estimated that Starship launch costs could potentially drop to as little as $2 million per flight. Even if building a comprehensive station required 50 missions, that would amount to about $100 million in launch expenses. Considering the fabrication of integrated modules and systems, the overall cost is likely to be between $500 million and $1 billion, a fraction of the $150 billion spent on the International Space Station, ISS. Space's vision for a Starship-based space station is not only bold and innovative, but also fundamentally achievable. It represents a complete reimagining of how humans will inhabit and operate in the space environment. With its large capacity, durable, reusable materials, and cost efficiency, the concept promises to revolutionize space habitation, making it more achievable than previously imagined. What do you think? Would you consider living on a Starship space station? Please indicate your agreement with a yes in the comments below, or if you have a more compelling alternative, please share your insights, and don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel to stay updated on SpaceX's incredible progress in the field of space exploration. SpaceX undeniably faces many obstacles in its quest to transform Starship into a functional space station, and overcoming these challenges will be critical to making the project a reality. Initially, SpaceX will need to determine the most effective approach to converting Starship into a module suitable for space station applications. There are two primary alternatives. Initiate a standard Starship launch while sequentially deactivating the fuel tank for the purpose of reusing the interior, or alternatively, build a dedicated space station module on Earth and deploy it fully assembled. Both methodologies present significant constraints. If SpaceX decides to convert Starship while in orbit, it will require the use of cutting-edge technology, specialized robotics, and a carefully orchestrated logistics framework to ensure the transformation is carried out safely. Conversely, if the module is built on Earth prior to launch, SpaceX will be tasked with devising a strategy to transport this massive structure into space while ensuring its stability in orbit until the arrival of additional modules. Another significant challenge lies in integrating Starship's various modules into a cohesive and operational framework. Unlike conventional space stations, which are engineered for interconnectivity from the start, Starship was originally designed as a rocket rather than as part of a modular space station. Achieving compatibility among Starship-based modules requires sophisticated docking and connection technologies coupled with precision engineering to ensure stability and balance. Ensuring the functionality of the station is another significant challenge, as a fully operational Starship-based facility will require a significant energy resource. While solar panels can generate a certain amount of power, the station's vast dimensions and the sheer number of systems on board may exceed the capacity that solar energy alone can sustain. This may require additional power sources, perhaps nuclear or other advanced energy systems, to ensure long-term operational continuity. Furthermore, ensuring a reliable supply chain for food, water, and essential goods will be critical. With a substantial number of individuals on board, potentially in the hundreds, the station's life support and resupply demands will far exceed those of the International Space Station. SpaceX will need to develop a highly efficient logistics framework, perhaps using Starship for routine resupply missions. Time presents a significant challenge. While SpaceX has yet to achieve a successful orbital mission with Starship, NASA has set a timeline for deorbiting the ISS by 2030. However, Musk has proposed compressing this timeline to a span of just 2 years. If SpaceX truly aspires to replace the International Space Station, it will have to navigate not only the complex technical hurdles associated with building a Starship-based facility, but also executing the launch of the inaugural module in accordance with NASA's timeline, or Elon Musk's bold vision. On a positive note, SpaceX is steadily making progress toward its ambitious vision of building a Starship-centric space station. While Starship has yet to play a direct role in the construction of the space station, its development is proceeding apace, with critical systems undergoing significant refinement. The ascent process is undergoing refinement, with critical elements such as the engines, cowling, and heat shield achieving stability through continued refinement. The re-entry process continues to advance with each test flight, as SpaceX has already achieved a major milestone by successfully landing a Super Heavy booster using the Mechazilla arm. Additionally, significant progress has been made in space station operations with the successful testing of the ability to reignite the engines in the vacuum of space. With this progress, SpaceX is advancing to the next stages of Starship development, which include payload deployment, landing of the ship using Mechazilla, and establishment of a refueling system in space. Starship's design continues to evolve, with version 2 currently under development and version 3 anticipated to follow, potentially enhancing its capabilities for space station operations. Inside the station, SpaceX has offered insight into its aspirations with Starship HLS, a variant designed for lunar landings. While intended for lunar exploration, its interior design provides a glimpse into the aesthetic potential of a Starship-based space station, featuring spacious, fully equipped living accommodations and advanced onboard systems. In addition to the spacecraft, SpaceX is also upgrading its terrestrial infrastructure, including production, launch, and fuel supply systems, all of which will be critical to the sustainability of a large-scale space station. The company has articulated bold aspirations, envisioning the annual launch of hundreds, if not thousands, of Starships. Furthermore, SpaceX has a tremendous opportunity to gain invaluable experience. The company is actively involved in the construction of commercial space stations such as VAST, Axiom, and Starlab, gaining invaluable insight that will guide the development of its own station. Additionally, as NASA's primary commercial collaborator for ISS operations, SpaceX has the expertise necessary to deftly transition into stewardship of the next generation space station modeled on Starship. Despite the hurdles ahead, the Starship space station continues to be an exciting and aspirational endeavor, one that holds significant potential for the future. That's it for today's episode. See you next time, and thank you for your support.